From the Plural Site Orbital Headquarters in Salt Lake City, I am Jeremy Morgan. And
Jeremy, this is Azure This Week. It's not Linux. What are you doing? Can you? God, some people. Jeez. Now, I'm Lars Klint, and I'm indeed at Plural Site Headquarters in Salt Lake City. And this is Azure This Week, not Linux. I have three things for you this week, including DDoS simulation, static web application updates, and AKS downscaling modes. And a special guest too, so stay tuned. Several times on this show, we've talked about cyber attacks and especially distributed denial of service attacks, known as DDoS. Every time we've mentioned how Azure is preventing the vast majority to the point that you, never notice and just go on with your life. And that's great, of course, but what if you want to know what happens in the case that Azure isn't up to the job? Well, how will your app react? How will your database perform? And how will your integrations cope in the case of a DDoS attack? Now, apparently Microsoft had the same question. So this week, a new collaboration with Red Button was announced for simulating just that scenario. This includes a fully integrated Red Button service simulation environment with three distinct stages. Number one, a planning session with Red Button to map out the attack simulation. Step two, a controlled attack based on that plan, which lasts 3 to 6 hours. Number three, a summary of findings and recommendations based on how your cloud architecture performed. Now, you can only simulate attacks against Azure-hosted public IP addresses belonging to the Azure subscription of your own, which we validated with Azure AD before testing. And that makes sense. You know, and this isn't a platform for actually doing DDoS attacks. Use the link in the description to get all the details of this new collaboration as well. One of my favorite services on Azure is static web apps. These apps require no server-side rendering and are usually built with JavaScript frameworks such as Angular, React, Vue, or even Blazor. I like Blazor. There are other ways to use them too. That was new. There are other ways to use them too. Last week, Wayne announced the stable URLs for static web apps, and this week, a few more neat updates were announced for the service. Improved DevOps integration, which means you can choose Azure DevOps as a deployment source for even more seamless CI/CD workflows. You can link both GitLab and Bitbucket repositories to static web apps with a simple bit of YAML. Delicious YAML. And finally, you can now skip API builds. That means you can bypass the automatic build and deploy the API built in a previous step. So why would you do that, I hear you ask. Yeah, no, I definitely heard you ask it. Yeah. This is to keep the build time minimal if you know the API isn't changing, for example. Small improvement for sure, but it can make a difference over time. And here's the latest Pluralsight developer advocate, David Neal, with a quick message.
Is 2022 the year of picking up cloud computing knowledge? Then you should check out ACG's free plan. You get access to free courses and quizzes, plus learning paths and original series content. There's even free course content. Right now, you can try Identity and Access Management for Azure, or perhaps you'd prefer Introduction to Networking on Azure. You don't even need a credit card to sign up. You can just jump straight in and start. I'll leave the links in the description.
If you've used any scaling services in the cloud, you know that this is one of the core appeals of cloud computing in general. Having services auto-scale to cope with increased demands for your Nicolas Cage random face generator is paramount for your success. Azure Kubernetes Services, or AKS, is one of those services that lets you scale up and down. But when you scale up, you allocate and provision new nodes. And when AKS scales down, they're deleted. This can be an issue, like if there's any data on those nodes that you want to keep. Now, hooray, fix is here. AKS will now let you decide if you are deleting or just deallocating, also known as stopped. Stopping a node stops the charges for the compute, but any data services like storage attached to the node is still chargeable. So you're still paying, but you get the benefit of much faster operation speeds from cached images. Read much more on how this works in the docs linked in the description. That is the news for this week. Are you going to try out the new big red button? There's much more useful and entertaining technical content coming from us, so stay tuned to both the ACG and the Pluralsight channels.
Linux yet?
Hang on. Jeez. We'll see you in the cloud. Keep being awesome cloud gurus. Jeremy, you can come back now.